Hey everybody, welcome to the Crypto McKain YouTube channel where I bring you daily updates and news on cryptocurrencies and some hand-picked stories that I found interesting to keep you updated. So without any further ado, let's get going. First thing we're going to check on, of course, is going to be coin market cap over here. We're going to come up and we're going to see that the Bitcoin dominance sitting at 42%, ETH at 19. Our total market cap is $2.1 trillion. It's kind of crazy how small that is, guys. See, gold has a market cap of $10 trillion. Just gold by itself. I'm sure we're going to get above that. So, of course, Bitcoin, always in the top spot, followed by Ethereum and then Cardano. They're doing great. Solana's moved up a little bit. They're number 7. They did have a little bit of trouble with their rollout this week. But, man, if you're processing 400,000 transactions a second, there's probably going to be some bugs, right? See, is Dogecoin still at the top 10? Hey, we're still number 9. Go Doge. Still number 9. Alright, let's see what the top gainers were. Cosmos, Solana, of course. Just in the past 24 hours. Avalanche, Harmony, Bitcoin, SV, Quaint, ICP. And top gainers for the week. Avalanche, Cosmos, Ren, Curve, Hedra, Audius, SushiSwap. I knew SushiSwap was doing good. Alright, so let's go over here and check out some of these news stories, y'all. Acorns. The CEO of Acorns app says crypto is coming. Noah Kerner, the CEO of the savings app Acorns, told NBC that the platform is bringing the ability for its users to invest and learn about crypto. We're going to let people customize their portfolios and add individual equities and crypto into a slice of their diversified portfolio, much the way a money manager would advise you to behave. And this is great, guys. They may be trying to do it in a regulated way, but I think any crypto adoption is going to be the best thing. I mean, people talk about one world government and the mark of the beast, and guys, I'm here to tell you, it may be controversial, but it's blockchain technology. That's what's going to get us to this next utopian era. That's what's going to make it possible for all the technologies and any sci-fi movie or video we've watched for decades. That's what's going to make it happen. I'll give you a little more into my insight on that here down the way. Okay. Next, Yahoo. I guess I'll accept your stuff. Go away. We're just going to skip them for now. SushiSwap crypto platform victimized by a $3 million hack. Chief Tech Officer John DeLong said in a Twitter thread that the company fell victim to a software supply chain hack, according to ARS Technica report. The attacker inserted their own wallet address to replace the auction wallet at the auction creation, said DeLong in his Twitter thread. The hacker transferred 864.8 Ethereum coins, worth around $3 million, into their wallet. The affected auctions have been patched since the hack, DeLong said in the report. Patch patched. I'm not sure how they patched something on a blockchain. That's kind of iffy. Makes me not trust Sushi Swap. It's not. Even if they got hacked, I thought you weren't supposed to be able to go back and change stuff. So we're gonna see. Okay. AMC's deeper move into crypto cements Adam Aaron as King Silverback of meme stocks. He just looks creepy, guys. Right. AMC chief tweeted late Wednesday that his company has decided to expand its acceptance of crypto at its theaters after announcing just last month that it planned to accept Bitcoin by the end of 2021. Quote, cryptocurrency enthusiasts, you likely know that AMC Theaters has announced we will accept Bitcoin for online ticket and concession payments by year-end 2021. Aaron tweeted late Wednesday night, I can confirm that when we do so, we also expect that we will similarly accept Ethereum, Litecoin, and Bitcoin Cash. So this is great, guys. Here's another quote. I think at the end of the day, if Bitcoin is really successful, the regulators will kill it. And they'll try to kill it, said the Bridgewater Associates founder. But I think they will kill it, because they have ways of killing it. But they've made it clear that their stewardship at AMC is no longer supposed to do. On Reddit, AMC Bulls celebrated Aaron's tweet, with many referring to him by the honorific Silverback, and pointing to his leadership as the kind forward-thinking that will justify AMC's now sky-high stock price. One user I was quoted saying, I think Adam's actually hustling here. I'm sure they'll stockpile any crypto used as payment and make millions off of it. And they're probably right, but I think they should have accepted Dogecoin with it as well, guys. We're here. We're telling you, except fucking Dogecoin. Okay. So trillions of dollars. Kevin O'Leary reveals Bitcoin price prediction and crypto plan. Let's see here. Celebrity investor in Shark Tank Kevin O'Leary said he expects another $1 trillion worth of buying into Bitcoin and plans to raise his exposure to 7% of his portfolio by the end of the year, up from 3% currently. That's great. He's just kind of flipped around. Yeah, he said he's in support now. He's going to double his portfolio. It's always great to have backing from millionaires and billionaires, guys. Always, always great. U.S. probes possible insider trading and market manipulation at Binance. Authorities are looking into whether Binance or its staff profited by taking advantage of its customers, citing people with knowledge of the matter.
Quote, at Binance, we have a zero-tolerance policy for insider trading and a strict ethical code related to any type of behavior that could have a negative impact on our customers or industry, the world's biggest platform said in a statement. Company has faced warnings and business curbs from financial watchdogs from Britain to Germany to Japan, which are concerned over the use of crypto in monitoring and risks to customers.
The exchange, whose holding company is registered in the Cayman Islands, has scaled back its product offering so it wants to improve relations with regulators. The review involves CFTC investigators who in recent weeks have been reaching out to potential witnesses. The CFTC did not respond to a request for comment. But so, guys, I wanted to talk about the future. So I was saying that blockchain technology is going to rule the world. Now imagine your NFTs. Right now they're just kind of digital. They're sitting in your wallet. But bear with me here. Imagine a virtual reality world built on top of blockchain where your wallet was your unique identifier and number linked to you. When you logged in, you are able to view and interact with all your NFTs in a semi-3D environment. And they were there. You'd be able to display them. You'd be able to organize them. You could use them, talk to them, take pictures with your NFTs and post them on social media. Take it a step further. If everything's linked to the same wallet, you can go in a store. They could bring you up and you scan your wallet barcode and you walk away. If you go to a movie theater, you purchase the ticket becomes an NFT. They scan your wallet QR code and they know you have that NFT. Welcome to this movie. And then you keep it forever. It's yours. You bought it. Just think about the different possibilities we could have for full automation and referencing. We see all these technologies in movies and anime and sci-fi flicks, but they've always been just out of our grasp. With blockchain, I think we're finally there. And these realities over the next 10, 15 years, they're going to happen. And they're going to become an everyday part of our life, just like Facebook and Twitter is, even though they're horrible and addictive and abusive of their user personnel. We're going to get there. We're going to get to a point that we render them obsolete. We're not going to need them. Keep an eye out for an AR world or fully virtual world powered by blockchain technology where you can go in and interact with your NFTs and display them in your own area. I think that'll be the one that sets everything off. It's going to make it to this new generation. So, me, I'm 25, y'all. It's, you would call me a millennial, but I'm not this newest generation that's coming up. I got a little sister. She's 8. She don't give 2 fucks about crypto. She don't give nothing. She don't care. She don't give no shits. But you can do great in virtual reality gaming. So you take the two, you merge them together, and all of a sudden, crypto that's not tangible, you can't see it, it's all on a computer network. All of a sudden, it is tangible. You can see it, you can hold it, you can play with it, you can move it around. That's what we need. That bridge to make this intangible idea that everybody's got here, that we're holding as value, to make it real. Alright guys, that's all I've got today. Thanks for coming out for your daily crypto update. Let me know if there's anything else you want me to talk about. These are just some of my favorite stories that I've found around the web. And I'll be back with you tomorrow. Peace out.